Yeah, that's a good one. So folks, first of all, I'm really excited to sit here with the funniest people in this country. Listen, come on. You are the funniest.
No, we weren't. I'm going to dispute that.
Yeah, you're not going to dispute it. It's fine. It's fine. So I'm not at all going to attempt to be funny in front of all of you for the next 45 minutes or so. But what's the reason I've gathered you all around on this giant square table is because it's fascinating for me as an outsider to watch how the comedy scene in this country has just exploded. I read one article which said there's a 300% rise in venues across the country. You now have your own web series thanks to Vipul, humorously yours. You guys have massive social media followings. You guys hit 2 million. And I will have to officially say I'm really jealous.
Hit the bell icon on the YouTube app.
And Amazon has just announced, 14 specials with stand-up comics. I mean, this is just huge. Okay, so do you guys, first of all, have a moment when you just sit back and say, bloody hell, we've arrived? Does that ever happen? Or has it been sort of just a slow growth into this?
Oh, I think me and Karan have discussed this. We have gone through that and now it's at the other end, which is, what is the point of anything?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Now it's nihilism.
Existential crisis already.
I've already gone through 3.
Yeah, he's gone pretty good today. Karan is a veteran existential feeling person. Like, I went to Karan and I said, hey Karan, I'm feeling all these thoughts, etc. Karan's like, hang on, I have an email. He actually had a 3,000 word email where he's like, here are all the thoughts you will have and here are all the problems you will face and here's how to deal with them. Like a nicely formatted.
I want to write a what to expect when you're expecting book, but for YouTubers.
Yeah.
So you're the shrink for stand-up comics?
I think you? Just for Tanvik.
Karan knows all the answers. Karan mentally is 5 years ahead of all of us in terms of feelings. He knows what feelings and how to deal with them. And Karan is my shrink. He's my shrink.
Are you guys acquiring each other? What's happening?
Acquiring each other?
I know Karan, he is nothing like that. Chup chap rota hai kamre mein. Why is he getting so much?
It's easier to give advice than follow it yourself. Yeah.
But I
know if I followed this advice, I'd be happy. But it's easier to tell than me.
So I'll talk about the other end of the spectrum. Inka shayad abhi kar.
People don't talk about your happiness. It's very irritating.
Yeah. So
I don't
right
care
now,
how happy you are. Okay, take it.
Right, so it is I would say the growth rate in the last 5 years, when we started, we were the first batch of comics. Me, Tanmay, AIB wale sare. They were the second batch, I would say.
Yeah, I know, but when the three of us started, Aditi, Tanmay and you were already huge.
We weren't huge at any point.
No, we were oh my god, these guys.
Nahin, two people to, I remember, Rendo, I sent you on Facebook.
I sent you on Facebook.
Here, yeah. Okay, yeah. And I was like, what is it? Seats 30, 35 people? And I'm like, one day, maybe. Out of the blue,
30 whole 35 people, yes.
How sweet, come
but
on.
When we started, they were
so cool.
I remember in my first year, 2010, I went on stage just 3 times a year. And I would call myself a professional comedian in the market. Because there was no open mic, there was no show, bhi nahi tha, and we would just, bas, file mein likh diya, doc file, and it looked like a comedian. Ban gaye. Kuch test nahi. And now, if you see, I would say at least 300%, it's 10,000% growth in terms of venues, in terms of
see, but 10,000% of zero is still zero. Or so 3 bola tha. So
in terms of venues, in terms of opportunities,
this IITM right here.
And even in terms of revenue, all the corporates have warmed up to the idea of stand-up.
Of course, spoke about corporates.
Yeah, so this is an inside joke we have.
What is the inside joke?
Vipul does all the corporate shows. This is now a 5-year-old inside joke and it's held true for 5 solid years. People are like, are you getting shows? No. Guess who's doing them? Vipul Goyal.
Are you rich? Are you guys making a lot of money?
Vipul is, I mean.
No, everybody. I would say for all the comedians, they make a lot of money. They just lie in the interviews. If you want to know their true worth, just call their manager for a gig, they'll tell you the rates. Any comedian who's saying they don't make money, they're just lying. So I want to put this on camera. So no, stop lying.
We didn't say we didn't make money.
When
we said
I
you were
my
rich.
Check, I feel I'm so overrated. I don't deserve this. So yeah, this is true for all the comics, at least on this table.
But when you compare
it with any other actor or producer or...
Hey, but why compare with actors and producers? No, that's a very established industry. I mean, that's over 100 years old, right?
Yeah,
fair enough.
You know, so yeah. Why go there?
But even John Oliver has been around for like quite a long time. So why not compare?
But Seinfeld said in that HBO comedy special that it was just brilliant.
All of us haven't memorized.
When he talks about the fact that comedians are the most judged people in civilized society, and every 12 minutes somebody rates you. How difficult really is it to do what you guys do? Because you know it's easy enough to look at you and say, "Ha, so funny." Kya hoga? But Aziz Ansari has also gone on record to say people don't treat it as an art form, which it is.
Yes. So it's not very hard.
You know what? Nish Kumar, this comedian from the UK, has this fantastic joke about how stand-up comedy is the only job in the world where someone can point at something that you've just said that might have extracted a laugh and be like, that's not a joke. Because a guy could build a wall and then be like, guys, that's my wall. And someone will be like, yes, that's a wall. Correct. But with stand-up comedy and the fact that it is this sort of contextual craft, is that it's you'll never be... And I agree ki paise ban rahe hai, life chal rahi hai, matlab koi mar nahi raha hai. But the sort of the craft end of it is I just feel like we're all noobs. We've only been doing it for 5 years. And that in comedian years is like embryo. Like we are not even fertilized eggs yet. in the craft of it, of stand-up comedy.
Just give you perspective, right? After 1 year of doing stand-up, I was doing about 5 to 10 shows a month. When I went to the UK in London and I met some comics there. And they were doing 5 shows a night.
A night.
They were getting on stage 5 times a night. They would do a show, take a tube, go do another show, take a tube, go do another show. They'd start at 7 in the evening, wrap up at 2 in the morning. And then I was like, oh, as many shows I would do in 3 years, they would finish in like a month, 2 months tops. So when you see a Zakir Zak today, right, which is so refined, it's over 5 years that he's built. An average comic there would take a year or two tops because they'd just be getting on stage that much faster. And I always believe that Indian comedians especially had... Because if you watch stand-up globally, right, and then you start watching Indian stand-up, your comparison was always that directly.
Yeah.
Right, you would watch the absolute best. Which is why we did the Whose Line Is It Anyway style show here. We tried and then realized that why would people watch this when they could watch the best already on another channel, you know. So the comparison was immediately Chris Rock, Jerry Seinfeld. Because you've seen the best of the best of the best. Even though you've not seen them live, it's like watching every movie and then judging it with Citizen Kane or whatever it is. So,
excuse me, friends. Conversation has been derailed. Nobody's answering the question. I was just about to say. How hard is it to do? And I'd like to say it's not very hard. A lot of other professions are possibly way harder. To name something, soldier, doctor, but respectfully, doctor, soldier, engineer, their jobs are way high risk. Ek road bana diya, toot gaya, log mar jayenge. Hamara kya hoga? Nahi chalega, jo kal chal jayega.
मैं डिसएग्री करता हूँ कि क्योंकि हमारे में किसी का जान का खतरा है इसका मतलब नहीं काम आसान है
जान का खतरा भी है
हाँ और
खतरा भी है
दूसरी बात ये कि यार हर काम ना अपनी उम्र मांगता है ठीक है बहुत सारे लोग हमको लिख के भेजते ना कि यार मैं फनी होना चाहता हूँ कल से कितने पैसे मिलेंगे तो ऐसा तो नहीं होने वाला भाई तेरे से ठीक है और ना वो जिस तरह MBA आप ग्रेजुएशन करने के बाद MBA करने में आपको लग जाते हैं 5 साल वैसे ही कॉमेडी के साथ भी है आपकी अपनी तैयारी है वो तैयारी ज़रूरी नहीं है कि आपने स्टेज पे निकाली हो वो आपके लाइफ एक्सपीरियंसेस भी हो सकते हैं जो अक्यूमुलेट होके शायद कुछ वक्त में कॉमेडी के थ्रू निकल रहे हैं तो काम तो मुश्किल
है वो जो पीछे 5 years का जो जनता को एकदम से लगता है प्रिटेंशियस मूवी रिव्यू हिट हो गया अरे ये तो रातों रात स्टार हो गया लेकिन उसके पीछे की कन्नड़ को मैं उसके पहले से 3 साल से जानता हूँ वो ओपन माइक कर रहा था मैं 6 साल से मैं भी कर रहा था जाकिर भी 5 साल से कर रहा था तो ओवरनाइट सक्सेस कुछ नहीं होती वो जेल टाइम आपको करना पड़ता है अपने क्राफ्ट की तरफ जो भी है एक ये था कि कॉमेडियंस आर मोस्ट जज्ड पीपल यस बट कॉमेडियंस आर आल्सो द वंस हु जज्ड पीपल द मोस्ट
suddenly afraid.
Also, I don't think it's only comedians. Anybody on stage is they are being judged every 10 seconds.
Sure.
Seinfeld is a great man, but not always right.
Okay, but tell me, if you're saying it took 5 years of just hard labor to kind of, you know, get to where you are, How long did it take to find your voice? You know, your show was called In Your Face because you said in an interview that I want people to be uncomfortable and then laugh.
Yeah.
So that's your voice. But how long does it take to hone it and come to this place where you say, this is me?
I don't think I have found my voice. I have changed my opinion since then. I shouldn't have called that show In Your Face. Should have called it, guys, I'm a friendly person. nothing good comes out of making people uncomfortable. I don't think I have found a voice. I think anybody, I think Zakir is close to his voice.
I think Zakir is, yeah. Zakir, I think you know you found your voice when you see people, when you see that you can be imitated. Yeah. Like I saw one guy at an open mic and he's doing jokes and I'm like, this sounds like Zakir.
Zakir, yeah.
And just the fact that Zakir now
is a comedians try to do jokes like Zakir now.
Really?
Actually, other comedians
try. Which comedians?
Please tell some names.
Other comedians try, suddenly मतलब हिंदी बोल रहा है, suddenly कहानी सुना रहा है बंदी के बारे में.
Storytelling art form को अभी popularize Zakir ने mainstream कर दिया storytelling art form.
With useful tools like समझ रहे हो ना? देख रहे हो ना?
So Zakir, how long did it take for you to come to this point?
Yeah, 2011 से कर रहा हूँ मैं. तो और दूसरा मेरे को बहुत मज़ा आता है परफॉर्म करने में. मतलब मैं आई कम फ्रॉम अ म्यूजिकल फैमिली, तो मैं बहुत बचपन से मैं स्टेज देख रहा हूँ, पर कभी भी मेरे को ऐसा लगा नहीं कि मेरे हाथ पैर कांपते नहीं. लेकिन कॉमेडी में हर रात हर बार स्टेज पे जाने से पहले वो जो लास्ट के 15 सेकंड 10 सेकंड जब होते हैं, जब आपका नाम अनाउंस होने लगा, आप ऐसे 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 हो रहा होता है, और उसके बाद जब आप पहली बार जाके जब वो पहला लाफ आपको हिट करता है ना, तो ऐसा लगता है कि हाँ अच्छा अब काम शुरू हुआ,
गाड़ी स्टार्ट हो गई,
गाड़ी स्टार्ट हो गई.
तो वो बहुत खूबसूरत है, और वो जितनी बार आप स्टेज पे जाते हो ना, वो हर बार नया और अलग तरीके से आपको हिट करता है. तो जस्ट बिकॉज आई थिंक आई वॉज लकी इनफ दैट मैं पिछले 1.5-2 सालों से बहुत ज़्यादा परफॉर्म कर रहा था. मैं कोशिश करता था कि जहाँ भी जो भी कॉमेडी को लेकर हो रहा है मैं वहाँ रहूँ या मैं प्रेजेंट रहूँ. एंड आई थिंक लाइक पर्सनल एक्सपीरियंस ऑल्सो हेल्प्स. आई वॉज गोइंग थ्रू अ ब्रेकअप एंड देन थिंग्स चेंज्ड.
So everything is grist for the mill, na? Sab cheez.
हाँ हाँ. इस इंटरव्यू पे भी 5 मिनट लिख सकते हैं.
This is a great story already.
कोई नहीं, किसी एक शेर लिखा था बहुत पहले कि कामयाबी तेरे लिए मैंने खुद को कुछ ही तैयार कर लिया. कामयाबी तेरे लिए मैंने खुद को कुछ ही तैयार कर लिया. मैंने हर जज्बात बाजार में रखकर इश्तिहार कर लिया.
Oh, nice.
Top comment. Zakir bhai is best.
Thank you.
Top comment 10 बार रिपोर्ट.
Endorsing stereotypes.
Now you have to just eat some poha and be great.
Itdari poha.
But listen, you were saying that first laugh hits you, right? What if that first laugh takes too long? Like, what's been your worst open mic experience? Like,
open mic,
nothing
works.
Multiple stories.
Open mic is very bad, always.
It's
always. Yeah, it's always bad.
But that's the point.
Even if you do.
Really?
Huh? Yeah. If you go and kill at an open mic, then what is the point of it?
Really?
Yeah, if you. I mean, since you bomb so many times at open mic, you stop caring if the joke works or not, and that is when this joke starts working. When you don't care about what either people are going to laugh or not laugh, so you're actually taking that risk of saying, guys, this is my opinion and I don't care what you think, that is when they laugh. Okay, oh, you took that risk, haha, funny. Basically open mic's all in that.
It's just like workshopping your material.
Yeah, and I think, you know, I mean, it's okay to bomb in an open mic because that's where you go to partially bomb, partially get a bunch of laughs. It is awful to bomb at an actual show with jokes that apparently other people laughed at, but nobody in front of you finds
and
funny.
And they paid for it.
Yeah.
So you can't let a paid audience down.
Correct.
Like, so what do you do? What happens?
Feel so bad. That is why we work. Like, I personally look at open mics as even if I get one joke on point, even if I get one laugh, it's a successful open mic for me.
Nothing works as well as personalizing jokes for that context. I think that's something that we always, at least I always rely on.
That's one thing that...
And just acknowledging the failure.
Yeah.
Just being guys, it's not working. Pity laughs are such a relief.
Yeah.
No, it took so long to understand that you can say, like, I realize also that this is not working.
You know, so when you're doing like a monologue, a theatrical monologue, you're like, oh, I'm in character, I've got these lines. It's very difficult to break the fourth wall if it's not going well. But when you're on stage doing comedy and if something doesn't work, it is so amazing that we have the ability to just talk to the audience immediately, address the fact that it didn't work or it worked better last time.
or just say that your check is clear and it doesn't matter.
Talking to the audience.
Who cares?
Yeah, talking to the audience seems like the most impressed, like crowd's the most impressed, but, yeah, but it's actually the easiest thing.
Yeah, yeah.
It's the easiest thing, right?
But it looks like I've made a joke about it. I'm like, I've done it 50 times.
Crowd work is the easiest because they will never give you, because they're under pressure, because the whole crowd is watching them, they'll always give you stupid answers.
Yeah.
You ask them, what do you do? Work. Okay, thanks, great. Now, 50 joke le about work. So I think it's easy.
If a couple comes, then there's nothing. There is nothing they can say which is not funny.
Yeah.
Where did you do something wrong?
Where did you guys meet? How did he ask you out?
How long
have you guys been dating? There are 3-4 questions you ask, and you know you're gonna get comedy gold if you ask these
things. Answer mein gap ho jaye to
even just you look at a couple and be like, hello.
कभी कई बार ऑफिस में पहले आई आस्क के यहाँ पे सबसे फन कैरेक्टर कौन है जिसकी लोग वैसे भी लेते हैं तो अब वो आइडेंटिफाई करें फिर उससे कोई बात कर लो और जनता ट्रिप पे कि क्या रिसर्च की है
सी हु डज
मतलब मैंने ऐसे जो किया कि मेरे को पता ही है एचआर से फिर मैंने उससे रैंडम क्वेश्चन पूछा और उससे कोई जवाब दिया मतलब व्हाई यू गिविंग सो स्टूपिड आंसर्स आर यू फ्रॉम एचआर
आई एम सॉरी इतना मैंने आई डोंट रिलेट
मैंने इतना मैंने
कॉर्पोरेट शोस
मैंने इतना मैनिपुलेशन किया हुआ है
बट टेल मी व्हाट हैपेंस ऑन अ डे व्हेन द जोक्स डोंट कम इज देयर एन इक्विवेलेंट ऑफ द राइटर्स ब्लॉक फॉर स्टैंड अप कॉमिक्स
First of all, excuse me, I have problem with writer block.
Yeah.
I think it's a myth.
I don't think it works for actual writers, filmmakers.
Really? There's no such thing?
I don't think there's a thing. There's definitely writer's laziness, writer's frustration. But if you come, a lot of us, well, okay, for myself, if you come from like an engineering background, you did some job, you can't just like, aaj software nahi nikal raha yaar. Like, you have to write it. So you can approach comedy or anything in the same way. Just do something different. You have to keep hammering away at it and something comes out.
Is there a riyaz? Like, do you like film writers would sit in front of a computer and just, you know, struggle with a blank screen? Is that what you guys do as well?
And everybody's process is a little different.
I don't write on laptops. I write in a diary or I will just vocally, I will say and record it. Because what I feel is when you write in laptop, which is for me is, so you basically you try to clean up your language. अब मैं बोल रहा हूँ यार aerostress ऐसी होती है मज़ा नहीं आया ऐसा कुछ बोला and I'm writing it I would say they weren't very you know I will just try to clean it up so that basic essence because stand up is more about being your real self on stage so in that translation I used to lose out on that so
one second your example was aerostress ऐसी होती है मज़ा नहीं आया
<wrong. laughs>
बोलते
एयर इंडिया से डिसअपॉइंट होते यार बहुत बुरी थी एयरहोस्टेस मजा नहीं आया एंड आई एम लाइक फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल मजा नहीं आया मतलब उसके लिए नहीं थी वो पॉइंट जैसे पॉइंट भी जाने के लिए फ्लाइट थी आप रॉन्ग एक्सपेक्टेशन लेके चढ़ रहे हो और मतलब बुरी थी मैं मतलब तो एयरहोस्टेस जेट एयरवेज की जवान होती वहाँ क्या उखाड़ लेते हो आप मतलब वहाँ क्या होता है आप बस दो बार ज़्यादा ही मंगाते हो चाय भाई जो भी सो अब मैं उसको अगर वैसे लैपटॉप पे स्टार्ट राइटिंग देन दे से दैट एयरहोस्टेस वर नॉट वेरी प्रीटी आई डिडंट हैव फन वो एसेंस चले जाता है कि पीपल डोंट से लाइक
सो यू राइट और यू रिकॉर्ड
Nowadays I record on my because I'm also lazy. So I record kar leta hu apne because when you're recording aapka jo original tone hai jo rhythm hai wahi aata hai. When you're writing wo fir aap I try to clean it up and which then looks a bit superficial for me.
I realized whenever I write I sound like an MC at a Catholic wedding. So then I take the writing to stage and talk it out. And in between that MC for a Catholic wedding and who I become when I am put in this pressure situation is the narrative that emerges for the jokes.
Like everybody has their own style, like Zakir.
मैं लिखता नहीं
बिल्कुल नहीं फिर
तो मेरा ज़्यादातर स्टोरीज जो होती है मेरी वो डिराइव्ड होती हैं रियल लाइफ इंसिडेंट्स तो मुझे ज़्यादातर स्टोरीज का एंड पता होता है कि ये एंड में हो गया तो फिर उसके बाद जितना मैं बहुत लूज बाउंड स्टोरीज करता हूँ और माशाल्लाह से जगह बहुत मिलती है मुझे स्टेज पर भी मतलब लोग बहुत सपोर्ट करते हैं हाँ पता चल सुना
नहीं लेकिन फिर याद कैसे रहता है
अरे मैम साल में एक घंटा भी याद नहीं करोगे तो फिर क्या है
न्यू कॉमेडियन नाउ
I re-entered the comedy circuit like about 2 months ago, because I used to do comedy in 2011, 2012. The comedy was very different then. And then I didn't do stand-up between 2015 and 2016 because the ARE was taking up a lot of my time and, you know, almost went to jail and blah, 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 blah. So I feel like the audience has evolved over time, and this is a huge credit to the comedians that have come on the scene. Like Zakir says now, which is audience ko time deti hai. Us time pe wo nahi tha. Us time pe tha ki aapke paas 20 minute hai stage pe.
Cut, cut.
Bade, bade, bade rocket utaro aur nikal.
T20 format.
T20 format. Stage pe aao, kill, kill, kill karo, nikal jao. Now I've started doing comedy about my life, my feelings, and this is what I'm going through.
It's more personal?
Yeah, more personal. These are my thoughts, these are my theories, this is what I believe about the world and blah, blah, blah. So it's very, very, very different now. And it's largely credit to the successes of everybody on the comedy scene.
So do you write this? Do you script it?
Now I just have thoughts. Like he said, I have... Let me open my phone. And you will see in the voice note section, it's just a bunch of random, these lists will make no sense.
Keywords.
Like the first voice note, it just says Daikin. It's just about something I thought I had about the ACs. Next one, it just says fashion show. Third one, it just says Honey Singh thought. Fourth, this thing says
Honey Singh thought.
I want to hear that joke. What is the Honey Singh thought?
I don't want to play it. The Honey Singh thought is that, I think the thought was that we're looking at these songs now, basically how you look back at songs from the olden days and you feel nostalgic about them and you say that these those songs were great. And I think in 20 years, you will look back at Dope Shop and be like, yaar, wo bhi toh gaane thi, that was, you know, but Dope ke saath Shop, matlab kya, you know, Ghalib level rhyme.
Tukbandi.
So I think that the thought was that, and in that moment, I think I had a funny thought and I wrote it down. So now it's become more about, let me write it down. I started doing this weird thing where if I'm having a conversation with 10 friends, I'll just put it on record and I'll just keep it because I know that I'm going to get out of 5 minutes.
How do your friends feel about it?
Well, friends, they don't know. The recording is on.
They do not know. No. So you do it with some particular friends. Like I have a friend of mine who's, I love discussing politics with him. And whenever I'm with him, he says the funniest things. So I just keep it on and I know I'm going to get 5 minutes about politics. Like one of the bits that I developed was how politics is all about rhetorics and the emotion trumps over logic, and that's how it came about. And I know it's true for Vipul also. Vipul दोस्तों के साथ बकचोदी करते रहेगा.
हाँ, मैं टीवी ऑफिस में जाता हूँ, सबके कैबिन में घुस जाता हूँ, और सबको अपने जोक सुना रहा हूँ. कोई हंसता है तो मतलब यार, अरे बताना तू देना कुछ, इसमें थॉट आ रहा है. वहाँ पे पूल ऑफ 52 राइटर्स हैं, लोग बैठे हैं, तो मैं बहुत चुराता हूँ. उनसे मिलते हैं, लाइक दूसरे दोस्त अनक्रेडिटेड फ्रेंड्स व्हिच यू बाउंस जोक्स विद एंड यू गेट अ लॉट ऑफ कंटेंट फ्रॉम देम.
So there are different techniques everybody follows, but yeah. Mostly when you talk, you're way funnier than when you write.
Right. Yeah. But you guys also seem to have a very genuine camaraderie. I mean, you have done cameos.
In front of the camera.
Achha, this is all my benefit. No, cameos and humorously yours. Yes. You know, there's a sort of genuine appreciation of each other's work. So my question is, how much can you retain this as this scene gets bigger and more money comes in and you all become bigger and
see,
bigger?
See, my philosophy in life is like, if you're going through a good time, agar aapka acha face chal raha hai, be very, very good with your community. Because har artist ka bura time aane wala hai, wo unanimously chal raha hai, to aapka sinusoidal curve niche aane wala hai.
Ye Gautam Buddha ka philosophy hai, don't churao matlab.
Nahi, maine kaha bola very yaar. मैं मेरा पॉइंट तो कम्युनिटी वाला है, सुन तो ले चले, मेरा पॉइंट कुछ और है. तो इफ यू आर नॉट गुड विद योर कम्युनिटी ड्यूरिंग योर पीक टाइम, सो द थिंग इज कि मेरे पास ये होना चाहिए कल मेरा बुरा टाइम चल रहा है तो मैं एटलीस्ट कम्युनिटी में जाके काम मांग सकता हूँ कि कनन तेरे लिए ओपन करवा दे प्लीज. सो ड्यूरिंग द गुड टाइम माई फिलोसफी इज आई हैव टू बी वेरी गुड विद ऑल द पीपल, क्योंकि बुरे टाइम में मैं हाथ फैला सकूँ, यार प्लीज मुझे कुछ दिलवा देगा.
ये गौतम बुद्ध ने बोला.
Little selfish.
Karan Biswa, Zakir, and these guys are like, I have gone through bad times, and I know I have picked up my phone at 3 a.m. and called these guys, and I've been like, hey, I'm going through a tough time. So for me, this friendship trumps most things. Like, I know Zakir is going to be your friend for like the next 20 years. You know, eventually he'll be a movie star, so I'm answering my calls, etc. No, friendship for me, this friendship.
This one's gonna be a movie star much sooner.
Yes.
Yeah.
Hey, Tanmay came in a movie before all of us. You guys, Brahmin Naman, please watch.
Rong. Bing.
Romping.
Mr. X. Ragini MMS too.
But to answer the question, how much are this going to last? The comedians have a weakness that they really like funny people. So you can't hate somebody, even if they're
they're an asshole.
Yeah, even yeah. If I select clean comedian Biswa. Don't use such words. But even if you hate him for his success, he comes and cries a good joke and you're like, ab dosti karna padega. So, you know, I think
that's not true.
अंडरस्टैंडिंग है, मुझे नहीं पता सही है गलत है, पर मेरे को ऐसा लगता है कि हम अभी जितने भी कॉमेडियंस हैं हिंदुस्तान में, हम कंट्री का सबसे प्रोग्रेसिव और वेल रेड क्लैन. मतलब जोक चाहे हम अलग अलग तरह के करते हो, लेकिन हाँ, हम बेसिक लाइन हमको मालूम है कि सही क्या है और गलत क्या है. और सब लोग बहुत पढ़े लिखे और अवेयर हैं, हम लोग सोशली बहुत अवेयर हैं, हमको मालूम है कि करंट सिनेरियो क्या है, क्या चल रहा है, क्या नहीं चल रहा है, एज कम्पेयर टू एनी अदर फील्ड आई गेस.
लाइक और काफ़ी ब्रदरहुड है कम्युनिटी में इस वक्त. लाइक आई रिमेंबर ह्यूमरसली और उसके लिए अब सब स्टार कैमियोज हमें लेने थे और मुझे कॉल करना था और मेरे को डर लगा था कि मैंने एक साल किसी से बात नहीं की. मैं जनरली कमेडियन से शोज़ में ही मिलता हूँ, अगर कुछ साथ में शो है तो मैं टच में नहीं था. अब मुझे एक साल बाद में सबको कॉल करना पड़ रहा था, तो अंदर से वो तो था कि आप काम की जरूरत पड़ी तो फ़ोन कर रहा है, तो मैं थोड़ा सा डरावा भी था. तो मैं प्लान बना रहा था पहले तन्मय को रूप में लेता हूँ, वो आप बोलेगा तो सबको तन्मय के नाम पर सेल करूँगा. मैंने ना कर दिया आप क्या है. तो बट वो डर था कि यार, क्योंकि यार फेवर तो मांग ही रहे हो. बट मैंने सबको कॉल किया और विद इन टू मिनट्स मतलब सबने एग्री किया, कोई स्क्रिप्ट नहीं कुछ नहीं कि हाँ यार करेंगे, कोई दिक्कत नहीं. तो वो मेरे लिए बहुत वैसा मोमेंट था कि यार अगर मैं अब किसी को भी यूनिवर्सिटी और उसके बाद हेल्प करना चाहता हूँ, मैं हमेशा आई एम ओपन टू
दैट. प्ले करने को
नहीं, क्योंकि हमारा सीन ना, हम लोग अभी खड़ा कर रहे हैं, ऐसा नहीं कि वो हो गया है, वो इंडस्ट्री बनी नहीं है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल रोस्ट जब हुआ तब मेरी इतनी बात भी नहीं होती थी इन लोगों से, पर जब रोस्ट हुआ तब हम सबके रेट बढ़ गए.
जैसे इंडिया में तीन लैंडमार्क कॉमेडी इवेंट्स जो मुझे पता है जो इंडस्ट्री चेंज हुई, फर्स्ट वाज ग्रेट इंडियन लाफ्टर चैलेंज, वहाँ से कॉमेडियंस को इंडिविजुअल शोज मिलने लगे जो फिलर आइटम्स थी. सेकंड वाज कॉमेडी नाइट्स विद कपिल, उसमें जनता में ये एक्सेप्टेंस आ गया कि हाँ भाई ये ले सकते, कॉमेडियन किसी का भी मजाक बना सकता है. और थर्ड वाज AIB रोस्ट, जिसकी वजह से एकदम से बिल्कुल शूट अप हो गया डिजिटल और ये लोग सब TV पे आ गए. तो दिस वर द थ्री लैंडमार्क इवेंट्स जिसमें कॉमेडी ने प्रोग्रेस किया.
Nobody has answered the question.
एक और
no one, not one person. The question was, will your friendship scale with comedy का scale?
एक second. I have another point to make here, related but not actual answer. I think if you are a comedian anywhere in the world और तेरे को कोई दूसरा language का भी comedian मिलता है, there is an immediate connection because you have been through similar experiences on stage. So, I don't know, this is great man Seinfeld speaking again. Usne bola ki I would much rather hang out with another comedian than my wife or some shit like this.
Wife nahi bola.
Oh, it's great.
Wife.
I don't have wife. But I think that sense of...
It's a bond.
Yeah. It's a different kind of bond. Ultimately, he knows that I am judging him by the joke.
So, yeah.
And that's not true. Is that true, Zakir?
Friend,
true?
Nobody likes you.
No, person first before
what
joke.
What everybody is saying is true for this table.
Never.
Yeah. Because okay. I think, Anupama, there's inherent this thing here because all of us are actually friends before comics. This is not true. I have heard Biswa talk about other comics and not friends with a lot of comics also.
I am friends with everybody. Wife is a problem.
मुझे पता है कल मैं कॉमेडी करना छोड़ दूं बिस्वा मेरा दोस्त रहेगा.
वेल प्लीज
वो तो आई है 2 साल से.
हाय आई एम अनुपमा चोपड़ा.
प्लीज लाइक शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब
टू फिल्म कंपेनियन.
स्वैग हिप हिप हुर्रे.
यू डिड इट आल्सो.